Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Kentucky Fried Catfish. And I'm going to get started by showing you what I have done with the catfish that I bought at my store. I just got a pre-packaged version of catfish. And since it's just Rick and me today, I didn't want a whole lot. So I have about three or four fillets here. And these have been soaking in milk for about an hour. And also after that, they have been sitting out on the counter for about 10 minutes to get them up to room temperature. And this is what they look like. I'll just kind of dig in here and show you how they look. This milk has the purpose of getting them good and moist, and also it takes away some of the fishy flavor. So I'm just going to go over here to the sink and drain that milk away. We don't need it other than for its purpose that has already occurred. So we'll just let those drain a bit while I go on to something else. But my hands need to be washed. Excuse me just a second. Never have a dish towel when I need it. Okay, so I've got my fillets here and they're just kind of draining a bit, which is fine. They don't have to be particularly wet or dry, just drained. I'm going to mix up a blend that is going to be the coating mix that we're going to use for our Kentucky Fried Catfish. And the main thing is going to be cornmeal. So I have 1 cup of cornmeal that I have measured out right here. And to that, I'm going to add some nice spices. This is going to be flavorful, but it's not going to be over-flavored. This is seasoned salt. Get any brand that you like, and you will need 1/2 tablespoon. So I'm just going to put that in since I know these are getting mixed together, and it will be a simple way to do it and save on some dishes. Then we have ground black pepper, and I need 1 teaspoon of that. You'll see that these look peppery a little bit on the coating. And then, let's move along here, we have onion powder. I need 1/4 teaspoon of onion powder. There we go. And then the last thing for this mix is garlic powder, 1/4 teaspoon of garlic powder. Now I put it in this measuring cup that was kind of tall, and I got a nice teaspoon so I could just stir this around. And you might notice my salt sitting over here. I'm not ready for that yet. That's not part of this mixture. But when you get this mixed around, just put it in a flat dish. Something like a Pyrex dish I think would be good, because you're going to be coating your fillets and you want them to be able to lie down in this coating. So just go ahead and put it somewhere like that. Maybe even an elongated dish, a tray or something might be nice. Just spread that out so it's ready to receive some catfish fillets. All right, now what I need to do is take care of my oil. I have it over here already. And I didn't set my jar out, but I have a large jar of peanut oil, and I used enough to make this about 1 inch up in my iron skillet. So you want 1 inch or 1.5 inches in a heavy skillet, and you're going to fry these on the stove. Now you could use a deep fryer if you want to, but the method I'm showing here is going to be on the stove because we've done a bunch of deep fried stuff already, and I don't think I've done anything like this. So I'm going to turn this on, and it needs to get to a temperature of about 350. And I do have my thermometer right here. It's a candy / deep fry thermometer. So I'll just keep checking to see when this is about ready. And then we'll come back and coat our fillets and just dip them into our hot oil. And they will fry up in no time at all. We'll have catfish. I'm ready to start frying the catfish, and I think that might get hot. So I'm going to take my jacket off and show you where we go from here. Your catfish fillets are drained. You need to salt them. So the salt was sitting there. This is just ordinary salt. take 1/2 teaspoon and sprinkle it over all of your fillets. I have 3 fillets, so that's about right for 3. And I'm keeping an eye on the oil. It's hot, but it's not quite at 350 degrees yet. And I probably will put these in with it a little shy of that because I don't want to have it smoking or to burn anything. So just get these salted up and maybe rub it in a little bit if you can. Then it's ready to take a fillet and just coat it completely and roll it if you want to so it gets into every crevice that might be there. And I think I'm going to turn this up just a little bit. And I'm going to sprinkle just a little bit of cornmeal into that hot peanut oil to see if it looks like it's going to cook. Yeah, I think that'll be fine. Now, that's probably a little shy of where I really would have the maximum benefit, but I'm going to very easily and gently put this in and let that start frying. I'll put one more piece in and just do 2 for you and finish the rest up later. But again, you want to just cover this completely, get into all of those cracks and crannies with your cornmeal mix because you want a nice coating and that milk provides a base for it to stick to. But you've got to really work and try to get it in there. There goes the second one. And really, I don't have room for more because that's frying up pretty close to the top. You might want a pretty large skillet for doing this. Just going to turn it down just a bit because it's still frying nicely. Probably I should go away, and when they're beginning to get done, I'll come back and show you how to check for doneness. I'm ready to take up my catfish. If you will prepare a rack like this, if you have one, over paper towel, that is good. If you don't have that, just put it directly onto paper towel. Now, when your catfish stops bubbling, or quite a lot of it has stopped and these begin to float up to the top, they are done. And you can also kind of tell by the nice brown coating when they are done. So I'm just going to go into this one and lift it out, try to drain as much of the oil back into the skillet as you can. And then it goes right here. Isn't that lovely? And then the other one that I fixed for you, right here. And there we have the 2 that I made while you were watching. Now I'm gonna finish up here because I have 3, and then I'll come back and serve this up to you. I just got my 3rd fillet off of the stove. It just got done. And I did mean to tell you that I cook these for 3 to 4 minutes on each side. And you just need to turn it once. If you want to, you can turn it a second time if you want it a little browner on one side. But we're ready to serve this up. So let me just go for this one here in the middle. And you need some kind of a flat spatula like this. And then I'm putting it on a plate that I've already prepared, and it has some things that you've seen recently. You know, I did a cheeseburger and fries casserole, and I had all of these waffle fries left over, so I just fried them up in a deep fryer this morning. So you've seen those, but that's not what I wanted to show you. You've seen this, which is our company coleslaw. It's just a little bit different take on coleslaw if you want to use it with this dinner. And then we have our nice piece of catfish. And this is Kentucky Fried Catfish. So I'm putting it over here with my display. I have some chest pie that I made recently. And actually, it's being uploaded right now. I'm having trouble with the YouTube uploader. So I don't know if you'll see it today or not. But or tomorrow or the next day, we'll see about that. And then of course I always end it out with a nice glass of iced tea.